Hello everyone, I'm Jean, the TCM practitioner and instructor in Victoria, BC, Canada. Here is my online class for ENT and eye problems for TCM practitioner and acupuncturist. The book we use I put below here. I can help students to study and review for the class. Let's start. So ear illness, with a ear separated by anatomy, outer ear, middle ear, and inner ear. Like the eye illness, we start from superficial of the eye, middle of the eye, and then pretty deeper inside of the eye problems. So when we're talking about ear problems, we're still talking about from superficial, outer ear problem first. Then we go to middle ear, then go to inner ear. So the first illness we're talking about in the outer ear. Yeah, outer ear, we have a channel connected with middle ear and open to outside. So sometimes some inflammation happens in the outer ear. So that's basically we're talking about outer ear problems. So clinically, it could be acute one and could be chronic one. Most cases, they may start from acute one, and some people possible have some underlying deficiency there, then they will change into chronic one. Most acute case will be cured during acute time. So basically we say acute inflammation happens in the external channel, ear channels. So mainly symptoms is painful there. Yeah, it's painful there. People complain ear pain. And if we're looking or checking, we can find some redness and swollen on the ear channel. Sometimes even go to like outside superficial of the ear. Severe kind of case, maybe some pulse. So chronic symptoms, yeah, chronic symptoms, like people is not that painful. It's not that like a rhino swollen there, but basically they feel always itching in that area. So that's generally, that kind of inflammation could be very, very severe. And some of them may be not that severe. That's depending like what's the recent cause. And also how about the patient's constitutions. So that's basically we're talking about inflammation happens in the outer ear. So let's talk about acute inflammation first. Yeah. Acute inflammation, when it happens, ear pain, ear pain. So that's basically is like a kind of sharp in there. And even when people eating food, they feel some painful in the ear. Or maybe find the ear is kind of pulling kind of sensation in there. So the typical symptoms for acute inflammation, ear pain. And then if we're checking the outer ear, and the channel there, there will be swollen, redness, and some diffusion. So that's second symptoms and the signs. That's locally. Other symptoms and signs, similar like other acute inflammation, happens in other part of the body. Patient will be have fever. So usually this fever is gradually getting a little bit high, but not high fever. We say high fever is 39 degrees. So basically around 38 to 39. And another symptoms, like we're talking about, aversion to cold. Yeah, aversion to cold. And the people feel sick. In this kind of stage, if people go to laboratory check, usually white blood cell will be increased. And especially we know in white blood cell, we have five different kinds of white blood cell. And mainly neutrophil is one of them, that the number will be increased. So that's basically acute inflammation happens, clinical symptoms and signs. Then we talk here about chronic. Yeah, chronic inflammation happens. The signs is a little bit different with acute one. So we say chronic can come in with like acute, not totally cured, and stay there for a long term. Usually we talk about months problem. So here, mainly is itchy. Yeah, mainly is itchy. Maybe a little bit painful, but not that severe. And if we're looking locally, still swollen there, but maybe not that rhinitis. And still possible have some secretions. Or maybe sometimes it's twisted there, or maybe a little bit bleeding there. But generally say, chronic patients don't have like a generally all over uncomfortable feeling, like no fever. And if go to laboratory test, blood cells, maybe just normal, because that's the chronic process there. So we put these two patterns together for this illness. So we go to our pattern, wind heat pattern. So locally, we're still talking about local symptoms and generally our symptoms. So locally still rhinitis and swollen there. And the patient talking about painful. So we know wind heat usually is acute problems. External excessive problems usually is acute problems. So painful in the channels, if it affected the outer ear, they will be painful on the outer ear. So that's generally local symptoms. And the pattern symptoms, we still separate local symptoms and the pattern symptoms. We say fever and aversion to cold, that's EPI, external. Passenger waiting. And here should be go to local. Yeah, here should be go to local. Some diffusion swollen and in the external channels and possible a little bit pulse separations. And other symptoms, other generally pattern symptoms, we say. Could be have headache, yeah, could be have headache. Could be have running nose, yeah, some other EPI wind heat symptoms, maybe sore throat. So mainly for the pulse, and we say tongue, basically we keep the same, normal tongue, but for the pulse, it's floating and rapid. And the patient got acute, like a common cold, EPI wind heat attacking. So treatment principle, disperse wind and clear heat, and relieve locally swollen and stop it. Because these kind of patient mainly locally painful and rarely swollen. So the formula we are familiar already, we use few time already. So we use Encyclopedia, typically formula working for the wind heat pattern. So, 金银花, 连翘, 芦根, 桔梗, 薄荷. That's like originally in the Encyclopedia, and they modified adding 荆芥 and 蒲公英, clear some heat toxins. And the 荆芥 working to relieve external pathogens. And the 甘草 harmonizes them. So we modified from there. So relieve pain. So we add 夏枯草 and 黄芩. So basically, these two herbs. Is a clear heat toxin herb. In this case, patient has severe kind of pain. It's kind of more severe heat in there. So we more clear heat and toxins. And if they have more kind of discharge in there, we can add cushion. Kushen is pretty good herb, clear heat and help the skin healing. So that's we can add in there. So that's the first part and we're talking about wind heat part. The second part and we're talking about fire and heat. Coming from liver and gallbladder. So we say excessive pattern, that's basically is a wind pattern, internal pattern. External excessive is EPI, internal excessive pattern, mainly for orifice, coming from liver and gallbladder. So that's, we say that's excessive, internal excessive part. And the heat, So like even the part we can separate by eight principle, like excessive or deficiency. External or internal, cold or heat. So the symptoms, pretty similar, with the way talking about wind heat pattern. Still rainy swollen and painful in there. But for the pattern's symptoms, is different. We say feel hot all over, And the people thirsty and like a cold drink. That's internal heat symptoms. Dry stool, internal heat could cause. And another symptoms possible, like a patient irritability, or maybe more emotions, either angry, and scanty kind of urination, dark urination, and the right tongue with yellow tongue coating. And the symptoms can come in after a big emotions, then happens the ear. And the pulse, rapid pulse, 10 pulse here, you can think about very pulse. So that's basically is internal excessive heat pattern. So our treatment principle, clear away heat from liver gallbladder and relieve swelling and benefit orifice or benefit ear. So you know what the formula we use already. Still, we talking about a few time already. 龙胆泻肝汤. King herb, 龙胆草. King herb, 龙胆草. You see the dosage is not that bigger compared with other herbs. But the 龙胆草 working very well. So that's the usually we talk about king herb is a big, big dosage. But 龙胆草 were not necessary to big dosage. It is still working. Other herbs, 黄芩, 栀子, we are pretty familiar already. Clear heat herb, clear heat herb. And 泽泻, promote urine, urination, clear heat from the urine. 生地黄, cooling blood. They have some tonic function, but compared with 熟地黄, they are more cooling blood. And the dangui go to the liver, nourishing liver blood. Xiakucao especially clear heat from the liver channel. Gancao, qi tonify and hamnai, both from the. So we still can modify it from there. Still can modify from there. If a patient have a big amount of pus, 皂角刺 is good herb. 皂角刺 is good herb to relieve pus. And severe thirsty means internal body fluid is damaged by the heat because that's the internal heat. We add 南沙参. We have two different kinds of sashen. Yes, sashen is intonified herbs. We have nan sashen, we have bei sashen. They both intonified. Yeah, they both intonified. But for internal heat situations, nan sashen working even better. If we don't have nan sashen, bei sashen still working. And my mandu, still intonified, moist and tonified. And they didn't talk about here, if a patient thirsty, what kind of herb you thinking we can add in there? We have a special herb, specially generate body fluid. 天花粉, yeah, 天花粉 is a good herb, generated body fluid. So that's for this pattern. Then we're talking about the pattern is kind of a root deficiency and yang rising kind of pattern. So complicated pattern here. So root deficiency generally say mostly we're talking about kidney and liver root, liver in disease. And the young rising from the liver part. So the symptoms and the signs locally, yeah, because we're talking about the deficiency part, this part usually is more chronic one. Itchiness and uncomfortable feeling in the locally. Maybe still a little bit pus secretion coming out, but not that severe, yeah, not much. And the local skin, small roof and sinking skin, yeah. So chronic process, yeah, chronic process. Or maybe with the crester and in there, and some skin like a falling off, kind of scrum in there. So that's the local symptoms here. They missing generally pattern symptoms. They only put the tongue and the pulse in there. But generally you will know like in deficiency symptoms. Like we talked about the five center heat, heart flash, and if more go to liver in deficiency, frequent urination, night urination, low back soreness, knee sore. So that's basically some in deficiency symptoms in there. And the hyperactive affair maybe cause like a red face, even sometimes red eyes, or maybe dizziness, or vertigo, or headache. So that kind of symptoms. And the tongue, right tongue, maybe a little bit thin talking, thin coating, or maybe without coating. And the serrated means deficiency pulse, rapid is a heat pulse. So that's the root deficiency, bunch excessive. So we say nourishing in, and the moisting dryness, clear deficiency heat, and the remove swollen and benefit the ear. So the formula still are familiar formula, yeah, still are familiar formula. 治百地黄丸. So basically, we use formula similar like we use acupuncture points. Like we have more than 300 regular points, and we have even 500 to 600, even more acupuncture points. Like totally, we can go close to 1,000 points, but each time we just pick up like 10 points or maybe 15 points if on both sides, it's like about 20, 30 needles in there. So that means we need to pick up, yeah, we need to pick up more powerful points to treat the problem. And our formula, similar situation. We have a lot of formulas like coming from 3,000 years, but the common used formula just got about 100 to 200. So that's why like some formula repeatedly happens in there. So that's basically some typical formula we use many, many years. It's truly working well. That's why we still continually use it. So 知柏地黄丸 is 地黄丸 plus 知母 and huang bai. So zhimu huang bai certainly we use clear heat, clear heat. And di huang wan we tonify the qin, sheng di huang mu dan pi, shan zhu yu fu lin, ze xie shan yao. So that's originally di huang wan here. Original 地黄丸也是熟地黄 ，but in 知柏地黄丸 ，they changing 熟地黄 to 生地黄 ，because 生地黄 have more cooling functions， and then adding 金银花 and 夏枯草 ，we still say 夏枯草 clear heat from liver gallbladder channel and gallbladder channel go to the ear, and the jinhua pretty light, clear heat toxins. And if the patient has severe kind of itchy, on the, like the channel there, we can add some jinhua and cantui. Yeah, cantui is pretty good to relieve each kind of condition. Also, like some people have like kind of skin rash, eczema kind of condition, we can add some cantui to relieve each. Juhua is pretty light, and cantui pretty light. That will go to the orifice. And if skin bleeding, we can add 茜草 stop bleeding and 紫草 stop bleeding. These two herbs is the grass, still light, still can go to like upper part of body and go to the orifice.